So I've been making rope out of plastic bags. That's why I don't answer my phone much, because I'm trying really hard to finish making this swing before the nice weather's over with, because I want me and my kids and Brett to go outside and swing and enjoy it. Okay. This is four bags, four grocery bags. I cut them up into 23 of these. And I daisy chain them and twist them, and it makes one cord. And I take four of those cords and twist those together. Make one rope. I'm going to finish this fourth daisy chain real quick. So 16 bags all together makes one rope. Take this end and hook it to the hook I have on my front door. I like to use washers at the ends to hook them on the hooks better. I feel like it gives me more control and gives the rope more stability. So I just kind of thread that through and do like a lark's head. And got these simple hooks right here. I'm going to double count them. 31, 32. I like to be consistent, and sometimes I miscount. So it's always good to be sure. A lot of times when I twist these with my Dremel, it'll snap somewhere, and I used to get really upset and frustrated until the kitty cats explained to me that had the rope not, or had the cord not snapped, I would not have known where the weak spot was, and wouldn't be able to reinforce it. So I just reinforce it and keep going. But I do this with the Dremel because it goes a little bit faster. But when I twist the four cords together, I use the power drill because it has the option to reverse. And you have to reverse the cords onto each other in the opposite direction that they were originally spun, so that it locks the rope together. So this is the fourth daisy chain that I'm spinning into a cord. As you can see, the kitties are waiting just in case this snaps, which 3 times out of 4, I do a good job and I'm patient. And I can make it without snapping. But every once in a while, it'll snap. And the kitties cheer. They're really good to have around when you're building a rifle, too, because my eyesight is really bad. And when you're building a rifle, you've got pins and screws that you gotta fit just right in certain spots. And a lot of the time, those pins and screws will shoot across the room and there's no way that you can find it. But the cats go exactly to this spot that that piece is and point to it until you go and pick it up. Whoops. Trying to keep my area tidy. This is scraps. So I've got 4 cords right here. I'm going to run my hands down it. They get quite a bit shorter when you twist, of course. That's physics. Now, I've knocked this over so many times that I have figured out that if I lay it down, it's less likely for the tension from the cords to pull it down onto the ground, and I wouldn't want to break this power drill. So it's better for me to just lay it down while I'm putting these on here. And I twist this up on a low torque so that I can keep an eye on it. And then I go to right about here. Otherwise, it'll snap on me. It'll get loose as I first start out because I'm twisting it the other way, but then it'll come and start pulling me forward. Okay, now it's starting to pull me forward. So what I like to do is loosen it up and then pull it tight, and loosen it up and pull it tight, so I have a good feel of where it's at. I think it's good. I'm going to take this off the hook, lay that down, and tie a knot at the end of it. And kind of let it go a little bit. If I let it go all at once, it'll twist onto itself and I'll have to untangle it. See how it wants to twist onto itself. And I'll tie this end into a knot. See, I had these washers on this end. And the smaller washers on this end because this screws. Now the hooks over here are smaller, but the hook that's on the door is wider. So I'm gonna unravel this a little bit more. While I'm loosening up, I'm gonna clip the ends off of this. I know you want to eat it. So that is, see if it'll focus here. I see people go like this, so it focuses better. So I'm going to line this up. Untangle and wind. Untangle and wind. Goodness. This one actually tied itself into a knot. That's crazy. Seems like every craft that I become engrossed in develops some sort of a personality and gives me a hard time. Now, this was 16 grocery bags. And it made just under 17 feet worth of rope. And it's really strong. So. I don't tie these up. They will take the house over, and the cats would probably chew it all up. I just take some scraps, tie it in a knot. There's my rope. I'm making my swing with. We can swing and swing. That's it. Love you. Bye.